Aloha everybody, welcome back to the channel where I strive to help you make better WordPress websites for yourself, your community, and possibly your clients. I'm Chris Joles, and in this series of videos, I'm introducing you to advanced custom fields. In the previous video, I showed you everything about advanced custom fields and how to get started with your very first custom field, the text field. In today's video, I'm going to introduce you into the link field. It allows yourself or your user to input links into your post editor that will show up onto the front end. If you haven't downloaded Advanced Custom Fields, it's free. There is a pro version that I recommend and opens up your possibilities even more. I have the link down below. It's not an affiliate link, so go down there and just use it. And just a side note, Advanced Custom Fields does require you to go into your files and input some custom code. If that sounds scary to you, don't worry about it. I'll show you the whole thing and everything you need to know along the way. But it's good to know that Advanced Custom Fields also works great with today's modern theme builders like Divi that I use. And it will allow you to use Advanced Custom Fields without ever having to touch your code. So without further ado, let's get started with link fields in Advanced Custom Fields. Okay, so here we are back at our example post that we've been working on. And in the last video, we created this little box here with the author's notes, where the author could come in and write their final words. Let me show you that here in the post editor. So here's our post, and you'll see down here we created a custom field for text. And if you come over here to our advanced custom field settings in our WordPress dashboard, you'll see that we have a field group called author's notes. Now today what we're going to do is create an area that's going to allow the author to put a link here. And this will be your introduction to the link field in Advanced Custom Fields. We also want that field to show up here, and we will create it here. First of all, let's just go to our field types, come down here, and show that what we are going to use is a link field. We'll click on this, and you'll see what I'm about to show you is the field settings and how to use it in a template. Okay, so let's just get started. Now, if you're new to Advanced Custom Fields, look at my previous video where it shows you how to get started and shows things a little bit more in depth. In this video, I'm going to move things just a little bit faster, assuming you have some basics down on how to create field groups and so on and so forth. So here we are in our field groups, and we are going to go into our author's notes and edit. And you'll see here we have our first custom field for the notes. We have it set up to show up on our post. And we have our settings basic down here. So what we are going to do is add a field. And we are going to call this field link. We're going to press tab, and it's going to input our field name for us. Don't forget, it needs to be single word, no spaces, underscores, and dashes are allowed. Now we're going to select here our field type, and we are going to select a link. Okay, and so in this link, we are going to, let's just say, link to a product. So we will say, enter URL to product here. Will this be required? We're going to say no. If you do required and they do not enter a link, they won't be able to publish this post. So for now, we won't make it required. We are going to return first a link URL. Okay, this is probably the simplest way to use a link. So I'm going to show it this way first. We're going to have no conditional logic, and we do not need to wrap this in anything. So let's just close this field to make it easier to see. And you'll see now we have two custom fields. We can come over here and drag them around and change their order as well. And for now, we will just press update. Let's come to our post editor and give it a refresh. And you'll see here we have our spot here for our custom field. And what it's going to ask for is enter URL to product here. That's what we put there. And we're going to select this. We are just going to say apple.com. For now, we do not need a link text. We're going to open this in a new tab, and that is good. We're going to say add link. And you'll see it has our link here, just like any other link tab that we could edit, so on and so forth. We're going to update this, come to our post, refresh it, and of course, once again, we need to go to the back end and input this into our single PHP file. So let's do that right now. Okay, so here we are in my WordPress files. Yours might be going through an FTP program like FileZilla,
this website is on my computer, so here I am in my files. We want to dig into your content and your themes, and you'll see I have a 2020 and a 2020 child theme. Always create your custom files within a child theme. Okay, but we need to come over here and grab our single PHP file and copy and paste it over here. And you'll see I've done that there, and you'll see I have it opened here. So this is our singular PHP file that we were editing in our last video. Let's just give ourselves some room here. And you'll see here we have what we created in the last video, which was our first custom field for notes. And this is where the author will leave its notes and show up here. We also have a title. We have a class of it wrapped in a box. And you can see that all right here. So what we need to do now is get the URL link to show up. So let's go once again to our field types here, select our link so that we could go to the documentation page. Scroll all the way down here and you'll see how we could use the link field. You have two different types of ways to use this. You could use it with an array or a string. Now an array basically will go and collect all the information that you created in that field. So if you obviously you're gonna put a URL, you might have put a title, you might have put a target like the new window that we did, and all that is stored already in this get field function. So basically what they're doing here is creating a variable called link, and that link is equal to the data that's in here. Okay, and then they create more variables for the URL, the title, and the target that is equal to the get field and the data that is stored within it. And when you create these variables like this, you can input the various data in here. This is getting the URL, and then we could echo the title. We could echo the different things that have, let's just over here, you can see that it has the link target and the link title. That's using it in an array. Or what we could do is just return the link. And you'll see here it has a function. What it's doing is it's creating a variable that's looking at the field that we called link, or that they called link. Okay, so it's gonna say get the field, get the data that's in there, and create a variable called link. Okay, and so what it's gonna do is say if there is information in this link, then spit it out here. It's gonna spit it out right there. And that's it. So let's copy something like this. But first I want to show you that you could do just echo out this to get your link. Okay, let's just go ahead and copy that function right there. So the first thing I want to show you is that you could come in here. Let's come back in here to our little box here that we created. Give ourselves some room in our if statement. And we're going to paste this function here. Remember the function was the field and we called it link. So that's basically going to just get the field and display it. So we're gonna save this, come back over here to our post, press refresh, and you'll see here is our link that we created. But you'll see here it's not clickable and it's just the spitting out the URL. And that is not very helpful. That's gonna make our user have to come in there and copy and paste it into their browser. Let's make sure we wrap this guy inside this div. Put this down here. Save, refresh. Okay, and it's in our div, but let's create this into a link. So that is basically showing that you could use this function if all you want to do was spit out the URL. So let's go ahead and get rid of this guy. What we want to do is do something more like this. Just create a basic string, and this string is a basic link, okay? And you know what we're gonna do? We're just gonna go ahead and copy this, come into here, and paste it. Let's give it a quick cleanup here. This is the PHP, and we're gonna create a variable called link, and it's gonna get the field information that we call link, conveniently, just like they did. And it's gonna say, if there's information in that field, then spit it out here. It's gonna create an A tag, which is a link. And you'll see in here that they have created a class called button. Here we are in our href equals, and it's gonna spit out the link URL that is right there. Then also there's gonna be some data here like continue reading. Okay, this is what's gonna show up on the front end. And then we're gonna end this. Let's press save, come back over here and give it a refresh. And you'll see it has created a button because of that class that we had in there called class button. And you'll see that this goes down to apple.com. So this is gonna create a new, should create a new window, which it did not. And that's the beauty of creating something like this, because what you're doing is you could create all these variables for the new targets and stuff like that. Or if you know that you want every single one of these to open in a new window, you could just come over here within your A tag and press target equals new. Okay, save this, come back over here to our post, refresh it, and we're gonna open up in a new tab as you see that it says down below. So that way it's hardwired into your code, and the user, whether they select yes or no for it to open up in a new window, it's going to. Now, let me just show you an example. Let's get rid of this class over here that made it into a button. Get rid of that, save it, come over here, refresh, and you'll see now it's just a clean URL link, which is might be something that you want if you're creating links. Let's say this author wanted to reference different articles in which they got their information from. You could create links to your different references. If this was a product review that you were doing and you wanted to say something like, I love this product, coming over here and having the class button might be a great idea, so that way it shows up as a button. Awesome, and that's how to use the basic functionality of the link custom field. If we come back over here, let's show you an example of how to use the array. And what we'll do is go ahead and get rid of all this. And we're going to come over here and we are going to copy this PHP right here. We're going to paste it into our code. We're going to clean it up a little bit. So let's just go over this once again. Thankfully, it's all titled the same as our field that we created. But if we named it anything different than link, we could put that right here. Okay, so if it was going to be links, you would call it links. But whatever you called your field right here is what you want to put in there. Okay, this is what it's going to be looking for. So you want to have that in here. So this is creating a variable link that is pulling this data. It's getting the field data called link. If there is information in here in this field, it's going to create these other variables. Okay, so if this variable has information, it's going to create a link URL, a link title, and a link target variable. And these variables are looking for this variable's information, and it's going to be looking for the URL, the title, and the target. So basically now we have these variables that we could use in our HTML code down here. Let's just give it some space so we could see. Now, pretty similar to the last one, it's created a button for us, and what it's going to do is go to the A tag and to the href and echo out the link URL. That is going to be this information right there. It's going to create a target that we put in there, link target, and it's going to draw the data from the user's input of their link target. And you'll see here, they also created a variable that says if the link target isn't in there, then just do the self. And then finally, what it's going to do is spit out the link title. And this link title is what was inputted right here as link title. And if we remember, in our input field, we did not put a title. Let's go ahead and do that right now. We're going to come to our editor and we're going to edit our link and make sure that we have a title there. We are going to make a button. So we're going to say buy now. And we're going to update this and we're going to update our post. So now we will have data here. Okay, so that this link title will actually be picking up a title that we wrote in there. So there's our link title right there. We're going to save this, come back to our post and refresh. Uh-oh. And you'll see it's going to give us this nasty error. And you're going to beat yourself up over the head trying to figure out where you went wrong with this code. And you are going to rewrite this code again and again, but it's not your fault. So what we need to do is go back into our settings and change the fact that we're going to use this field as an array. So if we want to use this as an array, we need to change our settings so that it starts to grab all this data. So we need to come back over here to our field group and our link, press edit, scroll down here, and do link array. And there you go. Now it's going to go and grab all that data and create an array for us. We're going to press update. We're going to come back over here to our page and refresh it. And there you go. It's grabbed all that data and created that button for us. So let's come back over here. And once again, what we could do is remove this class here.
First, what I want to show you is that we could say, let's say we didn't want to show this title. We could come over here and remove this PHP and something like save it, come back over to our page, refresh it. And you'll see it's no longer pulling in the data. It's adding in there what we put in there hard code wise. So let's just backspace a little bit until we get our PHP back there that is pulling in the variable. That variable is going to go to the link and grab it, the title. So whatever you put in that title is what's going to show up on that particular link. So just to show again, if we came into our post and we knew this product was a certain bike, or whatever the item is, okay, update it, come to our post, refresh it, and you'll see once again, it's pulling in that title that we created for it. Don't forget to come in here to your settings, and if you're simply going to return a URL, this is all you need. And if you are going to return a link array, which gives you the ability to create your variables here in an array of variables and use them in many, many different ways within your website. Now, don't forget, there's a lot of different ways to do this. So let's see how it looks if we didn't add a link in our post. So we're going to remove this link, and you'll see it's not there because we are already using an if statement. So if this exists and if there's data in here, we're gonna run this and then we're gonna say end if. And if there is no data in there, then there's no data in there. Just clean up our code a little bit and we could add more notes. All right, so there we go.
And there you go. I just showed you how to input a link field into your post editor when you're editing a post in WordPress. Advanced Custom Fields has a variety of input fields that you could use to customize your WordPress experience. Don't forget to check out the rest of my videos on Advanced Custom Fields, where I show you how to make even more customizations to your WordPress website. In the meantime, don't forget to like if you found this helpful, subscribe, and I'll catch you next time. Aloha.